Hello students, welcome to EPG Parshala. I'm Dr. Savita. Today we are going to discuss about a module, Tourism Products, Regional and South India 2. This module is a continuation of the previous module on South India. Tourism products of Tamil Nadu, Pondicherry and Kerala are discussed in detail in this module. The ethnic, linguistic and cultural linkage between the states also discussed in this module, and students will get a better understanding of the general tourism. Characteristics of the states are also discussed. Tamil Nadu. Tourism marketing tagline and chanting Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu is known for its rich cultural heritage and ethnic identity of people. Tamil is one of the classical languages of India, and the literally meaning of Tamil Nadu is land of Tamils. It is the second largest economy of India and stands on the top chart of foreign tourist arrival to India. Intangible cultural heritage such as lifestyle, traditions, language and literature. Tangible heritage, for example, historical buildings, temples, natural attractions such as hill stations, beach resorts, wildlife sanctuaries, etc. attract large number of visitors to Tamil Nadu. Very rich history, as the rulers of Pallava, Chola, Pandava dynasties contributed a lot to the state of southern region. Chilapathakaran is treated as one of the greatest work ever written. The ports of Tamil Nadu had been connected with China, Arabian countries, Greece and Rome from the very early period. Another important literary work is Thirukkural, one of the very prominent leaders of Tamil people is Periyar, whose ideologies and philosophies still influence everyday life of people. Popular attractions: Madurai, Rameshwaram, Ooty, Kannur, Kanyakumari, Mahabalipuram or Mamallapuram, Kodaikanal. Natural attractions: hill stations, Yelagiri Hills, beaches, Marina Beach, Mahabalipuram Beach, VGP Golden Beach, Nagapatnam, waterfalls, Kottalam Falls, Hojankal Falls, wildlife, Madumalai Wildlife Sanctuary, Manar Marine National Park, Vedantagal Bird Sanctuary, religious spiritual Palani. Palani Hills have a very important place in the heart of Tamil people. It is the one of the abodes of Lord Kartikeya, the son of Lord Shiva. The idol of the Muruga in Palani was created and consecrated by Sheikh Bogar, one of 18 great Siddhas. Velankani. This shrine is an important pilgrimage center for Christians. This was once an important fort which had trade relations with Rome and Greece. Basilica of Our Lady of Good Health is the main attraction of this place and is known as the Lord of the East. Trichender It is Murugan Temple, Lord Kartikeya, son of Lord Shiva, believed to be older than 2000 years. In this temple, Lord Murugan appears to be with Rudraksh in hand in place of spear. Annual festival Skanda Shasti draws large number of tourists. Pajamuder Solai. It is located 16 kilometers from Madurai and highly revered by people. St. Thomas Mount, Mylapur, located at Chennai, it is a pilgrimage place for Christians. It is believed that St. Thomas, disciple of Jesus, was martyred here. Seasonal events, festivals. The main festivals of Tamil Nadu are Pongal and Diwali, pronounced as Deepavali. There are numerous temples in Tamil Nadu and every temple has its schedule of festivities. Thepam, floating festival, is celebrated in Madurai, and Chittirai festival is another major in the events calendar of Madurai. Kartike Deepam festival. This festival is widely observed in Tamil Nadu. It is a festival of lights. Thiruvamanalai is a renowned place associated with this festival. Temples are decorated with diyas. Chariot festival, Rameshwaram. This festival is observed during Shivratri. Thousands of devotees flock to this place during the festival period. Idols taken in decorated cars repulled through the streets. Chariot festival at Chidambaram. The annual chariot festival at Chidambaram is scheduled for 10 days and the day of Maharathosavam, which falls on the 9th day of the festival, Natyanjali Dance Festival, Chidambaram. It is a 5 days dance festival held in the month of February-March every year at Chidambaram. It begins on Mahashivratri and held in the Prakara of the main temples of Chidambaram. Tyagraja Music Festival. It is in January every year at Tiruvayuru, where the Carnatic music legend Tyagraja lived. Malappuram Music Festival, held in December, January every year. Renowned artists perform classical dance events during the festival in the backdrop of the heritage site of Mamallapuram. Cuisine. The cuisine of Tamil Nadu is distinct from other places. Filter coffee and rice-based dishes can be found everywhere. But the regional taste and delicacy of dishes vary according to the sub-regional areas. The popular dishes of Tamil Nadu are idli, vada, appam, upma as breakfast item. Lunch include a palette of dishes. The Kulambu is accompanied for paranthas, and a number of non-vegetarian dishes including seafood. Chettunadu cuisine is the region of southeast Tamil Nadu where the trading community Chettiar families normally live. The cuisine include aromatic, spicy and rich with nutrients. Nanjilandu cuisine is similar to Kerala cuisine, in which coconut is widely used. Kongunadu cuisine is the popular cuisine around Coimbatore, Erode, etc. Dance, music and folk arts. Tamil Nadu is the home for classical dance and music forms. Tyagraja, Muthuswami, Dikshitar, Syama, Sastri, etc. were the most prominent experts of Carnatic music through whom it reaches its present position. Bharatanatyam is one of the classical dance form developed in Tamil Nadu. The folk tradition include Kolatam, Karagatam, Kumi, Mailatam, Puliyatam, Vilupattu, etc. Pondicherry. Tourism marketing tagline, give time a break. Earlier known as Pondicherry, this small union territory was under the administration of French till 1954. It has four districts scattered at different places. Tamil is the official language and majority of the people are having the ethnicity of Tamil. The city of Pondicherry is designed on grid pattern and French influence can be found in architecture, cuisine and language. According to the historical records, the port had trade relations with Rome in an ancient days. Portuguese, Dutch, English and French arrived here in the 17th and 18th centuries. At present, Pondicherry present a vibrant picture of prospering state with high level of literacy and standard of living. It is one of the gateway destinations from Chennai and Bengaluru. Popular attraction, Auroville, Promenade, Beach, Handicrafts. Kerala, marketing tagline, God's Own Country. Kerala or Keralam is a small state situated on the southern part of the subcontinent. It is a marketing synonym for tourism. The state aggressively prompted its natural beauty and tourism potential. Kerala was part of state of Madras before independence and the state was formed in 1956 on the basis of language. It shares borders with the Tamil Nadu on the east and Karnataka on the north. The western boundary is Arabian Sea, which creates a long coastline of 580 kilometers. Kerala was known for high quality spices and condiments grown in the hill ranges for which traders from China, Arabia, Persia and Rome visit the state. Popular attractions, backwaters of Kerala, Kumarkom, Munnar, Kovalam, Shri Padmanabhaswamy Temple, Trivendram, Varkala Beach, Thrissurpuram, natural attractions, hill stations, ecotourism centers, waterfalls, beaches, lakes, islands, national parks and wildlife sanctuaries, Periyar Tiger, Silent Valley National Park, Thattekadu Bird Sanctuary, religious spiritual Ambalapuza, Shri Krishna Temple, Guruvayur Shri Krishna Temple, Sabrimala Sastha Temple, Kutmal Manikyam, Manarshala Shri Nagaraja Temple, Parasini Kadavu Shri Muthappan Temple, Athukal Bhagavathi Temple, Trivendram, Aranmula, Parthasarthi Temple, Mata Amrit Danmai Math Kolam, Meramon Convention, Sivagiri Pilgrimage Heritage. Meraman Juma Masjid, it was the first mosque built in India in AD 629. The mosque appears to be a temple from outside. According to the legends, Meraman adopted Islam and then proceeded to Mecca for pilgrimage. This mosque is one of the heritage monuments under Islamic condition. Jewish synagogue. The Jewish synagogue is one of the main attraction of Fort Cochin. At present, there are very few Jewish families stay there. Hill Palace, Triptunara. It is the first heritage museum in Kerala. The museum and nearby buildings represent architectural style of Kerala. The museum displays the properties of the Cochin kings, Horse Palace, Padmanabhapuram Palace. These heritage properties were once owned by the Travancore kings, built in traditional architectural style of Kerala. Bekal Fort. Bekal Fort is one of the few forts of Kerala which is built on the coast of Arabian Sea. It is situated on the northern part of Kerala. This fort once stood as the first line defense to check the enemies approaching from seaside. Saint Angela's Fort. A massive fort in triangular shape situated close to Arabian Sea once defended the Portuguese in this region. It was constructed by the first Portuguese viceroy Francisco de Almeida in 1505. In 1663, the Dutch captured it and sold it to Ali Raja of Kannur. In 1790, British captured the same and started using for their military purposes. Mujeres Project. This project is part of the Silk Road project of government. Once upon a time, Mujeres was a very important port in India, which had sea trade relations with countries in Asia and Europe. Ptolemy mentioned in this book, Periplus of the Ruthrian Sea, about this port of India. The heritage project aims to identify and conserve the cultural assets of the region, promote sustainable development of the resource, etc. This is the largest heritage conservation project in India and the first green project of government of Kerala. It was awarded PATA Gold awarded in the category of heritage preservation. The Kochi Mujeres Binhel brought international fame to this place. Kalpathi Street, Palkat. The Kalpathi Street is an example of typical Brahman Agraham. Kalpathi Rathotsavam is famous. People live here are mainly Brahmins who migrated from Tanjore of Tamil Nadu during the attack of Tipu Sultan in 1790s. The Raja of Palakkad sheltered them and rested them near the river Kalpathi. The street is also known for Carnatic music and traditional lifestyle. Fort Kochi. The palace. The place marks several historical monuments such as Dutch Cemetery, the Vasco da Gama Church and the Jewish Synagogue. This area overlooks the harbor and the Wipin Island. This place was also used as the storehouse of spices which were bought from hill areas. Aranmula. Aranmula is a unique temple town in Pathanamathila district situated on the bank of river Pampa. Aranmula Parthasarathi temple. This place is having a great cultural importance. The river temple traditions and the Aranmula mirror brought international fame to this place. Aranmula snake boat race is held during the Onam celebrations. The Valasadhya, a traditional feast organized at the temple. unexplored adventures, Idukki. The high range of Idukki are known for various adventure activities: trekking, mountain biking, off-road driving, water sports, paragliding can be done at the following identified places: Vegamon, paragliding, Wayanad and Munnar, off-road driving, Agastya Kudam, Pethalmala, Parambikulam, Ranipuram, trekking, Kovalam, surfing, Alappey, kayaking, Bhutathanketu, rafting, bird watching in coastal island, national parks and wildlife sanctuaries, Chambra Peak, Wayanad, suitable for trekking. Festival events. Onam. Onam is the biggest festival of Kerala. It is celebrated in according to the Malayalam New Year and to welcome the King Mahabali. Every household celebrates Onam with great enthusiasm. It is an occasion for many people to have a get-together at families, as many of the Keralites are working in different places. The celebrations are now conducted week-long at state level. Snake boat races, folk performances, etc. are taken up different places. The day of fair's conclusion, Trivandrum, the capital city, is decorated with flowers and colorful lights. The procession attracts large number of people as various tablecs, live performances, fancy dress, etc. draw large number of tourists as well as local people. Vishu. The festival follows the solar cycle of the lunisolar Hindu calendar. In other parts of India, this day coincides with Baisakhi or New Year according to Hindu calendar. All family members gather at their homes and the day starts with getting darshan of Lord Shri Krishna in the decorated puja room. The eldest member of the family gives new dress or gifts to the family members. A special meal is prepared during lunch hours and every member of the family cherishes the time they spend together. In the evening, firecrackers are burned to celebrate the joy. Other festivals include Christmas, Eid, Ramadan, Easter, etc. Art, dance, music, Kathakali, Mohininatam, Thulal, Theyam, Kalapari Peyathu, Tholpava Kothus, Ayurveda. Kerala marketed its potential as an Ayurvedic destination and it yielded good results. The traditional treatment methods still attract lot of people from various countries. Ayurveda is considered as a major tourism product of Kerala. They serve in different dimensions such as medical tourism, health and wellness tourism, establishment known for traditional treatment methods and trained and experienced doctors and staff are supported by Kerala Tourism. It classified Ayurveda centers into two categories, green leaf and olive leaf, according to quality standards and services. There are several hundred Ayurvedic centers in Kerala, but it is worth to mention the following centers. Kottakkal Arya Vaidyashala, established by physician and philanthropist Vaidyanath P.S. Varier in Kottakkalam, 48 km from Kozhikode. At present, it has branches in major cities as well as herbal medicine manufacturing units. Shantigiri. Shantigiri Ashram is famous spiritual center and Ayurvedic research center in Kerala. It has Panchkarma centers and research centers. Other events, shopping festivals, a month-long festival take place in Trivandrum. Binail takes place once in 2 years at Cochin Travel Mart. Film Festival takes place at Trivandrum. Cuisine. Kerala cuisine is mainly rice-based, but a variety of sweet dishes are being prepared on different occasions. Kerala has three major communities which also define the cuisines. Vegetarian, non-vegetarian dishes are accepted at almost all occasions. Seafood is also widely used by the people. Some renowned food items are appam and stew, puttu, nool puttu, malabar biryani, karimen fry, etc. There are regional influences in the local cuisine. Souvenir handicrafts shopping. The following handicrafts are found in almost all places in shops of Kerala. Toys, coconut shell based products, brass and bell metal, coir based products, ivory works, Kathakali masks and herbal products. The handicrafts, textile products are also very popular among the visitors. A variety of herbal products can also be found in the markets of Kerala. The list of spices found in Kerala are found as mentioned below. Shopping, souvenir option, design, material name and district description. Spices, products, Idukki, Venad, black pepper, white pepper, lemongrass oil, dry ginger, cardamom, clove, nutmeg, star anise, turmeric, cinnamon, vanilla, turmeric, cambodge, kokum, tea Idukki, Vayanad, different types of tea, coffee, Vayanad coffee, beans, processed or coffee powder. So students, let's summarize now what we have learnt in this module. The five southern states of India offers vibrant and exciting experience to visitors. However, the experience can be customized to the requirement of visitors. A close observation on the description of the tourist attractions, products offering and marketing campaigns of the authorities of various states attract tourists from various states of India and across the globe. Tourist circuits connecting these southern states can offer a basket of attractive packages to the tourists, which satisfy the visitors. Diversity of India can be found in every region, but the overwhelming part is the hospitality of local people, irrespective of the state a tourist visit. Another interesting point to notice, though India is a large country with diverse ethnic, linguistic and cultural subgroups, the unity of people come forefront, which is very strange experience for a new visitor is concerned. We can summarize that a trip to India is not just a trip, but an immersion to experiment the true experiences of enlightenment to a great civilization that pondered. Vasudev Kutumbakam. Thank you.